Live from the campus of the Georgia Institute of Technology, it's the 2014 Georgia Tech Inventure Prize.
Let's get the scoop from Team Sanivation.
Sanitation is a story that is often untold. It tends to be the elephant in the room in conversations about global issues because of cultural taboos and disgust, when in reality, everybody poops. My name is Jasmine Burton, and I'm joined by Aaron Cobb and Brandy Banner, and we are here tonight to talk dirty. If you know right now where the closest bathroom is, then you are among the world's privileged half that has continual access to a toilet. Because 2.6 billion people in the world do not have access to their basic sanitation needs and are expected to use these unsustainable pit latrines. According to the World Health Organization, water, sanitation, and hygiene-related diseases cost the world approximately $260 billion. But more importantly, over 1 million children's lives every year. This means that over 4,000 children are dying because of preventable wash-related diseases every single day. We are Team Sanivation, and we are bringing innovation to sanitation. We've designed an inexpensive mobile sanitation solution intended to reduce oral fecal contamination and the spread of wash-related diseases. It is my pleasure to introduce SafiChoo. As I walk through the SafiChoo system, Aaron has so graciously volunteered to model it for us. So if you can imagine, this prototype on the ground would be elevated on this 2-foot-tall structure above ground with this 3-part drawer system beneath it. The user would walk up a ramp, walk over the device, and sit or squat on top of the device. She will then open the smell flap, which reduces the prevalence of disease-carrying flies and the odor. The seat has 2 holes that separates urine and fecal matter. The separation of waste is further amplified in this drawer system, where solid wastes are collected in the top drawer, liquefied wastes are collected in the middle drawer, and used anal cleansing water is collected in the 3rd drawer. This filtration is really important because it decreases the concentration of contaminants in the waste. So then she reaches back and she uses the manual bidet, which reduces the need for the users to wipe with their hands, which is a common and current practice around the world. She will then close the smell flap, and then now she has completed a hygienic sanitation process. We have presented the SafiChoo to the CDC and to the Norwegian Refugee Council and received their support in piloting our design.
Team lead for the Global Water, Sanitation, and Hygiene Team at the Centers for Disease Control, CDC. Sanitation is a real public health problem throughout the developing world. And I fully support the efforts of Team Sanivation to develop new tools that will help people gain access to safe and improved sanitation. Thank you.
My name is Luriaman Alex. I work for Norwegian Refugee Council, Kakuma, and I support Team Sanivation.
If we receive funding, we will be able to go out into the field, beginning in Kenya, to work with CDC researchers to pilot and refine our design. We were also featured on the CDC website on World Water Day a few weeks ago because of SafiChoo's novelty. At the end of the day, access to sanitation is a basic human right that too many people around the world have been denied. Because of the low cost, the sustainable design, and the intentional reduction of oral fecal contamination, SafiChoo has the potential to save millions of lives. We are Team Sanivation. And we believe in SafiChoo. And now the question is, do you? Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
So I'm here with Courtney and Lane, who are sisters of the team members. So tell me, how dirty did it really get?
It got pretty dirty pretty quickly. They were used to spending hours a day in the lab talking about poop and sanitation and filtration. And Jasmine would come home when we'd have family dinners and just continue with that conversation and think that we were all used to it, and we weren't. But we got used to it pretty quickly, and we all support her, and we're really proud.
It must have been really appetizing. It's like, yes, I'd like to know how much poop you looked at today.
Yes.
So did you ever walk in on your sister with a very weird stance in the bathroom, trying to perfect the squat?
There were a few times. I'm kidding. But I think these girls, there's a rumor around men that women don't poop, and these girls have showed that not only do they poop, but Georgia Tech girls can create sanitation systems that are going to change the world. So pretty incredible.
Absolutely. You know, Faith, a few years ago, I was in the audience where someone told me that there are no girls at Georgia Tech. Hello, all girls team, pooping, classy, all of it all together. Seriously. All right. If you think teams,
The moment we've all been waiting for. May I have the envelope, please? Thank you. The winner of the 2014 Georgia Tech Inventure Prize is...